I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my turn, yeah, till I met you. You called my name and I mine.
But that's okay.
Sitting the whole time.
Let's just get going, you know? Hey, guess what?
What?
We've had such an overwhelming amount of emails coming in.
Really?
To the Arkansas.
How many?
News. Like,
incredible.
A lot.
A lot.
Incredible.
So many.
It was just to the point that
I was able to open one.
Only one.
There's so many emails that I got to see some good news that people have been sending
me. Some good
news. The Overmans emailed our kids news at Racing Christian. Hello, welcome.
Hello.
They were just saying that Waylon got to invite Landon over
to
play.
Good times.
And yes, because we no longer have that stay-at-home order.
It's lifted a little bit so people can go out and enjoy time with each other.
Right.
So that was, man. Waylon, I'm glad you got to have a friend over. That's amazing.
That's awesome.
Really
and then
fun.
Maddie, she had a birthday.
Really?
A birthday this week.
Happy birthday,
Maddie.
So, hey, here is a guy that would like to sing a happy birthday for you. So.
Is it you?
No, but
no,
I've been told I look like him a little bit.
Really?
So, take it away.
Happy, happy birthday to you. Happy, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear.
Anybody who has a birthday in May.
Happy birthday to you.
Hey, happy birthday, Maddie, and anybody else who has a birthday in May.
Absolutely. Happy birthday.
Hope it was good.
Is.
I wonder.
What?
Can Okay,
future
top idea
will be.
Of
yes.
Birthday quarantine. What do you think would be the best birthday quarantine?
Best birthday quarantine?
Because I've seen like people drive like birthday parades where they drive by. Like, is there any like other cooler ideas that you can
We support? Had one.
Lemon Oreos.
Lemon Oreos.
Video games.
The best quarantine birthday. I mean,
Scott's birthday was April 29th. And
right in the middle of quarantine.
That's right. Yeah. So we surprised him, which is really hard whenever you're all in the same house, by decorating the back of the car, the hatch part. And we decorated the whole thing and put his cupcakes in there and some root beer and ice cream and all different kinds of stuff. And then we went to friends' houses.
Oh, nice.
And we'd open up the hatch and we'd be like, it's our happy birthday party. So we took it to different houses.
Ooh. Mm-hmm.
And then we had gifts for them. So it was it was a giving birthday party, wow, which was super
incredible.
Fun.
That was amazing. Selfless.
And I was, it was, it's, you know, it's him. Yeah. He would rather give gifts
Master Scott.
Most of the time than receive them.
Thank you, Master
you know?
Scott.
He has a heart of gold, that guy.
He does. Mm.
Master Scott.
Amazing. So that was an idea, and it was fun.
It was good. That was
but
good.
I think one where maybe you were the only one at Disneyland. Oh, quarantine
man.
At Disneyland.
That would be
that could be interesting.
Amazing.
Interesting.
Amazing. And you could take your lemon Oreos.
I could.
You could.
Or I could just.
They do travel.
Share with nobody because.
Keep my lemon Oreos to myself in my blanket fort.
That would be fun. A sweet giant blanket fort.
I mean.
Right.
With tunnels.
So, Segway, we
I like segways.
Didn't we do
I've
an,
never ridden
an
on a Segway.
Experiment recently?
We did do an
we
experiment.
Did.
Should we show that?
Absolutely.
Okay,
yes.
here's our experiment.
You can also do this experiment at home as long as you have parental
permission.
Supervision
and
permission.
And permission.
So here it is.
Peroxide. Peroxide.
Oh, let's see what happens. We only have one chance at this.
Where's the chance?
That's disappointing. It's moving.
It is moving.
It's growing.
Give it time.
It's really slow. We could do a time lapse. That'd be cool.
So what do we got here, Judy?
What's that say? Soap.
So we add the soap into the bottle?
Did
you? No. The hydrogen peroxide first.
The peroxide first.
No, it's not.
Food coloring.
Oh, yeah, food coloring. You put the food coloring, yeah, just on the side there.
I don't know how to make flowers, but by golly, experiments, watch out.
Watch out! All right, you guys, you got your soap in? Okay, get your soap in there. In the bottle.
Over here. Take them off, here.
Come on! Oh, look at you. Did you squirt yours?
A little bit more. I squirted some more soap in there.
Look at that.
Man, science.
Look at that. Mm. I like that yellow.
That's an interesting little effect it gives.
The craftiness of that.
Thank you.
It is. It's
Thank you, cameraman Jeff.
Ooh. You're amazing.
Ooh.
Oh. That's beautiful.
Oh, no.
What not to do? And now it is in his hair.
That was underwhelming.
That was. We
that,
tried.
That was not at all what I was envisioning.
When you
but
try
I mean, it was
hard,
fun and it
succeed.
Was cool.
I mean,
and we did get to see that chemical reaction and what all happened. You know,
awful.
And testing out yours
Slowly.
Was beautiful.
It was. I did try
gorgeous.
Yes.
My best.
Great
we
job.
We have a photo of his little. experiment. Here it is.
Creation.
I mean, look at that color.
Oh, amazing.
It's like a tree or like a flower looking thing.
I found this amazing video of the world record elephant toothpaste. Now, this is one you should not try at home, but this was amazing.
Let's look.
Whoa, that was amazing.
How did they clean that up afterwards?
Oh.
They should have a separate video of that.
That is a good question. I wonder if they were thinking about that whenever they made it.
Usually not.
Like
in my case, like if I make a mess, I usually don't worry about cleaning it up. My wife gets on to me for that. It is what it is.
Though we did clean up after ourselves in the kitchen.
True.
We did.
Good job, us.
Gold stars. Mm-hmm. So, speaking of like, it kind of looked like they got trapped in that video. It's like they were covered. That got me thinking, like, have you ever had a time that you needed rescued?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Maybe not from elephant toothpaste, but like a time you needed rescued.
I needed.
Like, maybe you were lost, or the time that you almost got hurt, or, I don't know, just get out of trouble.
Yeah. You know what? Whenever I was a little girl, so much younger,
Not that much younger.
Mm-hmm. I had just learned to confidently ride my bike.
Ooh,
and
nice.
I was going out on my own,
Big steps.
So I went out from my house and I was taking a ride and I was headed back home.
Did you have a helmet on?
This was pre-helmet days. I know, that's hard to even imagine, but pre-helmet days and a banana seed, I think. So
ooh,
I'm just dating
seed.
Myself right
ooh,
there.
Wow.
I was coming across the road, and where I used to live, there was this amazing hill that all of the kids loved to ride down. They just loved to coast the hill. I looked both ways. Nobody's coming. I start crossing the street. Didn't realize somebody was at the top of the hill getting ready to go.
Oh, man.
And they did. They went right into me and just flattened me, and I was stuck there. I was laying on the pavement, and my bike's on top of me, and then the poor kid that was coming down the hill, he was laying right there, and I couldn't get up. I was stuck underneath everything.
Ooh.
His bike, my bike, and I was just laying there, and all of a sudden, my big brother comes out. Running out there, and he scoops me up, and he takes me into the house, and they get me all bandaged up and everything. But
nice.
I was crying quite a bit, you know.
Understandable.
But anyway,
thank goodness for big brothers.
I know,
right.
Amazing big brother.
Mm.
Yeah.
Amazing.
How about you? Anybody?
Well, there's one time I went over to my good friend Jeffrey's house, and he needed help to go to a field to drop a tractor off, and so he was in the tractor, I was on the four-wheeler, and I was leading the way. And so we were driving a couple miles, and then all of a sudden I need to make a left-handed turn. And so I started to make a left-handed turn. I was 13 at the time, so my driving skills wasn't the greatest, okay? And so I started to turn, maybe took it a little too fast, faster than I should have. And then I turned in, and then all of a sudden I started going towards a barbed wire fence. Either I had a choice of staying on the four-wheeler and crashing into the barbed wire fence or jumping off in the ditch. So I had two options. And so I chose the latter, and I jumped off the four-wheeler right before the fence. And I was going like 20, 30 miles an hour. Oh. So we were booking. And so I jumped off and the four-wheeler crashed into the barbed wire fence and I was just laying in the ditch and all of a sudden my friend comes over and the tractor jumps out and the first thing he says to me is, "What did you do to my four-wheeler?" And so, but then he was like, he helped me up and wiped me off and got some bandages for my knees. But yeah, I mean, yeah, if you would, like, I would have bloody knees and it's just a time that, you know, I just needed some help, you know, to get back up. But I know it. That was, what a time to be alive. What a time to be alive. Yeah. What about you, Zach?
Yeah, so I have another, you know, kind of bike story, I guess.
Ooh,
you know,
nice.
My mom's sister and I were out riding bikes one time, and we came upon a nice open parking lot that had speed bumps in it. And speed bumps work well for what they are intended for, both vehicles and bikes, I found out.
Nice. Mm.
So I thought, you know, at the tender age of I don't know what, but young boyish stage, I was like, man, I can go kind of fast over the speed bump, and it doesn't seem to do anything, right? Oh, I was wrong, and I was very wrong. Speed bumps on bikes and speed on the bike mixed together equals big jump on bike, but hard landing on said pavement. Mm-hmm. So,
boom.
My mom described it as I was Supermaning over my bike.
Oh.
And kind of landed on my elbows and knees.
Ooh.
And,
ouch.
It was a grand old time, let me tell you what. Jumping over speed bumps in a parking lot on a bike does not feel good.
Mm.
Either when you land or when you take off, because that's a hard impact. And so
that
didn't go well. But thankfully, my mom was there and my sister. And my sister got to, you know, kind of like carry / guide my bike home as my mom like hobbles along with me, carrying me back to my grandma's house.
Oh man.
Where then I get all bandaged up and I still have scars to this day.
Do it again. Did you do it again?
Would you do it again? I've never gone over a speed bump in a bike.
Yeah.
Quite like that again. But I have done other stupid things on a bike.
Oh yeah.
That involve speed and jumping and pain and
nice ramp.
You know, one time I got a rock stuck in my knee. That was fun.
Ew. Yeah.
I bet my mom doesn't remember that story because I never told her. Sorry, Mom.
Now you know.
But now you know, Mom.
She does.
But yeah, so you know, there's just fun times that you can have on a bike if you're not careful.
The stuff we learn at our kids' news.
Our kids' news is
that's amazing. So you know what that this reminds me of though. Like there's a Bible story in Acts.
Another one?
About good Peter.
Yes.
About a good friend Peter who needed rescued.
This is Peter.
Hey-o!
Who was one of Jesus' disciples.
Yep.
Peter told people about Jesus. There was a king named Herod who tried to stop anyone who tried to tell others about Jesus. He arrested Peter and took him to jail to be executed. While Peter was in prison, the people of the church prayed for him. The night before Peter was supposed to go to trial, he was sleeping. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord stood before him. The angel woke Peter up and said, "Quick, get up." The chains fell off Peter's wrists.
Whoa!
Then the angel told him to get up and get ready to go and to follow him. So Peter left the cell, but all the time he thought was happening wasn't real and that it was just a vision. They passed by the guards, and when they came to the iron gate, it opened for them on its own.
Wow, awesome!
They were walking through the street when the angel suddenly left him.
Wait, what just happened?
Peter finally realized that this was all really happening and that God had sent an angel to save him from what King Herod and the Jewish leaders had planned to do to him.
Wow!
He went to the home of Mary, where many believers were together praying. When Peter knocked at the door, a servant girl came to answer.
Hey, let me in! Peter!
When she realized it was Peter, she was so excited that she ran inside to tell people instead of letting Peter in.
I'm so honored.
It's Peter!
The people inside thought the girl was wrong and said, "It must be Peter's angel." But Peter kept knocking. When the people finally opened the door, they were amazed. Peter told them about what happened and all about how God sent an angel to rescue him from prison.
God can do amazing things.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
God can do amazing things. Preacher. And here's the thing. I know, like, you know, the last couple months, it's kind of a downer, just everything that's happened, like with the virus and quarantine. But I believe, I have faith that God is doing amazing things during this time.
Most definitely.
You know, and doing amazing things in your lives at home, in our lives, and the lives of everybody in the world. Here's the thing, though. Mm-hmm. We need to believe that God is doing these amazing things. Mm-hmm. So in Galatians 5:1, it says, "It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm, then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by the yoke of slavery."
Ooh, that
and
sounds
so,
like a great memory verse.
Yeah, it does. And so, I mean, if we, just with everything that is going on, if we just have all this burden that's over us, life's going to be hard. Mm-hmm. And so if we give our burdens to God, the God who can do amazing things, mm-hmm. all it's just going to feel like we're saved. We've been rescued from all our problems and worries. Oh, amen.
And
amen.
There's freedom in that.
There's freedom in that. And that's
Jesus,
good news, guys.
Absolutely.
That is
good best news.
So I think that's it.
So
all
today.
Right.
So
I don't think we can get any better than that.
I don't think we can.
Amazing.
So we might be back next week. We might not. Who knows?
But keep emailing us
at ourkidsnews. Oh, hey.
Wow, magic clothes.
Also, thanks, producer Corey. If you, if this looks like your stuff, good news.
If you would like to graduate.
Good news. We found it.
Here it is.
We found it.
This one right here.
I found this.
It's not my size, but someone.
This is a nice, ooh.
A lion sweatshirt.
MSSU. So if this is your stuff,
I bet MSSU misses you.
Come get it. If not, it's going to.
Right in June, we'll be coming back to classes.
Yeah.
True.
So check the lost and found.
Because in July, this is going to Goodwill.
It's not just a dress-up box. It is actually
your stuff.
This is going to Goodwill in July.
We found it. We put it in a box.
So you come get it.
So now you need to find it in your box.
This isn't all.
The ball is in your court.
Who knows what's in there?
It is actually in the basketball court, too.
Yeah.
It is.
So the ball is really in your court. Literally.
Right. On that, I think we should.
We will see you later.
Yeah. Hasta la vista.
All right. Have a great week.
Love you.
Goodbye.